Hello and welcome everyone. So today we will be doing numericals of VAT. So firstly I will explain you in short how it is calculated. So firstly we purchase some raw material, then we add our profit, then we sell. If we purchase 100, we have paid suppose VAT on it 10, so 110, but we write the amount 100, we make a different column of VAT credit available, that is 10 rupees is available, then we add profit 10 and we sell it on 110. Then we have to add VAT if it is 10%, it's 11. 110 121, this is sale, this comes invoice price. Now what we have to do, we have to do VAT liability. How much it is? 11 minus VAT credit available. I've told you here we have paid 10, this is input tax credit. I've told you in theory also input tax credit is available, so it is 10. So 1 rupees net VAT liability. So this is the basic thing or basic format, you can say, how we calculate VAT. Now I will take the module of CMA ICAI syllabus 2012 and we'll do some numericals from the module. So VAT is on page number 8.1, but I think numericals will be on page, yeah. So practical problems on VAT, example number 4. So what it tells, I will read it and I will directly solve it. So purchase by A and company for the month of December 2012, the purchase are rupees 1 lakh at 4% and 5 lakhs at 12.5%. This is purchase. We have purchased goods of 1 lakh at 4% and we have paid 4% VAT. We have purchased goods of 5 lakh and 12.5% of VAT. Now sales, VAT is charged on sale. So we will calculate from purchase the ITC, that is input tax credit, which will be available when we sell. So how we'll solve? We have sold 2, that is sales 3 lakh and 3 lakh. There are two sales, so we can write here 3 lakh now it's visible it is 3 lakh and 3 lakh plus VAT. We have to charge VAT. Here it is told that sales 3 lakh at 4% means we have to charge VAT 4% on the sale of 3 lakhs. So VAT at 4% is equal to 12,000 and here at 12.5% on this 3 lakh, because it is given, one here it is 4%, here it is 12.5% on sale. So here at 12.5% the amount becomes 37,500. So the invoice price is 3,12,000, 3,37,500. If you add these both two things, invoice price. Now VAT liability, it's 12,000. 1 and 2, I am telling about this. VAT liability is 12,000 minus VAT paid 4,000. How it is calculated? Here 1 lakh, we have purchased goods of 1 lakh and we have paid VAT 4%, that is 4,000. I have told you, you have to write the purchase amount. You don't have to add this and write here in purchases or in sales. So 1 lakh is purchase and on it 4% VAT, it is 4,000. It is VAT credit which is available. We don't have to do anything with sales. So here it is sales 3 lakh. We have paid VAT 4%, 12,000. Invoice price is this. So VAT liability is 12,000 minus VAT already paid I have calculated here 4000, so the net wealth is equal to 8000. Likely here also 5 lakh, the purchase into 12.5%, it comes to 62,500. So it is ITC which is available. So here what is the VAT liability? 37,500. So you write here 37,500 is the VAT liability, and what VAT you have paid already? 62,500. So net VAT is coming 25,000 in minus, that is excess of VAT is paid. So when you balance these two, 8,000 and 25,000, credit, final credit available is 17,000. It is very easy, friends. We have done sale, we have charged VAT, it is invoice price. This is the VAT which was liable. Then input tax credit is 4,000, which we have calculated 8,000. Like this, we have solved this. It is minus, that is, it is excess and it is to be paid. So if you minus, 17,000 is still the credit which can be utilized by the trader or the businessman. Now we'll go to question number 5. I will solve 4 to 5 questions, friends. Rest you have to do. Here it is. Compute the VAT amount payable by Mr. A who purchases goods from manufacturer on payment of 2,25,000 including VAT. It means in 2,25,000 VAT is included. So you have to remove VAT and take out the amount of purchases. So here we can write, purchase. It's 2,25,000 which is including VAT. So 112.5 into 100. So the purchase is 2 lakh. How some students don't understand this. So you can do one thing. 100 rupees is the selling price and the VAT is 12.5%. Here it is given. VAT rate on purchase and sale is 12.5%. So 12.5. It comes to 112.5. So it is including. Means this amount, 2,25,000 is including. So 2,25,000. So in Hindi I tell that 2,25,000 agar 112.5 ke barabar hai, to 100 ke barabar kitna? So it is 2 lakh. Means excluding VAT the amount comes 2 lakh rupees. So now you have to do again our format. Purchase 2 lakh and VAT credit 25,000. It is rough, friends, do not write it in the exam. So beer purchase is 2 lakh. Then here it is given profit, 10% profit he has to earn on cost, that is the cost is this. So plus profit 10%, it comes to 20,000. It come invoice sale price is 2,20,000 plus VAT is chargeable at 12.5% on this amount, that is 27,500. So the invoice price comes 2,47,500. Now again our format, VAT liability. What is the VAT liability? 27,500 VAT liability minus VAT credit which is available is 25,000. So the net VAT payable is 2,500. I hope you are getting. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment box below. Now we'll solve the question number 6. Compute the total VAT liability under state VAT laws for the month of October. Okay, input purchased within the state. I have told you within the state. Okay, capital goods used in the manufacture of the taxable goods 50,000. Finished goods sold, applicable VAT rate. Here VAT rate on capital goods is 12.5%. So there are two purchases here. It is a normal purchase 1,70,000 and capital goods have also been purchased. So the VAT rate on capital goods is 12.5%, means is pay tax credit 12.5% ka milega. VAT rate on capital goods 12.5%, input tax rate 12.5%, output tax rate 4%. So apne ko pehle to dekhna hai what he has sold. So we'll solve the sum. So here input purchased 1,70,000 plus 21,250 कैपिटल गुड्स 50,000 प्लस 6250. व्हाट आई हैव डन हियर, इनपुट 1,70,000. आई हैव रिटन इनपुट 1,70,000. इनपुट टैक्स रेट विद इन स्टेट 12.5%. सो व्हाट आई हैव डन, वी हैव पेड 1,70,000 into 12.5%, that is 21,250. Means when we purchased the goods, we purchased the goods of 1,70,000 and the VAT credit is available is 21,250. Likewise, I have done for 50,000 capital goods, 50,000, and here it is given 12.5%. So 50,000 into 12.5%, it is 6,250. So it is also VAT credit which is available. Now we have to see what is the sales done by him. So the sales is 2 lakh. It is given in the question. Like here it is given. Inputs. Finished goods to sold within the state 2 lakh rupees. So it is, sale is 2 lakh. Then we charge VAT at 4%. It is given. Output tax rate 4%. So we will charge 4%, it is 8,000. So the invoice price is 2,08,000. Then VAT liability, how much we have to pay. Now I will not write again and again VAT liability, I'll just tell you, please write down. So VAT liability is 8,000 minus VAT credit. What credit is available? 21,250 plus 6,250. So VAT already paid or VAT credit available is 27,500. So here again excess credit is available, 19,500. So he can utilize the excess credit in the further sales made. So this was the question number 6. Now we'll do question number 7. Yeah, it is now perfectly visible. Yeah, question number 7, compute the VAT liability of Mr. X for the month of January using invoice method. I have told you in India uses invoice method only. Computation of VAT. Purchase, he has done purchase 52,000. So 52,000 is including of VAT. So we have to take out the normal purchase, which is 50,000. Because the rate is 4%, VAT rate on purchase is 4%, so it is including, it is 104, so 100 kitna, so 50,000 plus yaha VAT credit likh do 2,000. Ye exam mein mat likhna aise baazu mein, bas for your understanding I am telling you. So it is ye, ab likh lo purchase kitna hai, ye amount likhna hai. VAT ka amount kabhi nahi likhte purchase ke andar, bas बियर परचेस लिखते हैं. फिर यहाँ लिखा है स्टोरेज कॉस्ट इनकर्ड. स्टोरेज कॉस्ट, ये जो भी कॉस्ट है ऐड करते जाओ. वैट इतना इजी है, बस ऐड करते जाओ कॉस्ट. ट्रांसपोर्ट ठीक है, 8,000 ऐड कर दिया. प्रॉफिट मार्जिन 5% दिया है. सो ये एक तो ये कॉस्ट हो गई 60,000 प्लस प्रॉफिट दिया है 5%. सो ये 5% हो गया 3,000, ये हो गया 63,000. नाउ सेल प्राइस आ गई 63,000 प्लस वैट. यहाँ दिया है वैट रेट ऑन सेल इज 12.5%, सो इस पे 12.5% लगाओ, 7,875. तो ये आ गया इनवॉइस प्राइस 70,875. यहाँ वापस आप लिखेंगे वैट लाइबिलिटी, कितनी है लाइबिलिटी 7,875 माइनस वैट क्रेडिट अवेलेबल, इट इज 2,000 रुपीज. सो नेट वैट पेबल 5,875. ऐसे सॉल्व करते क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. ये है एक, ये क्या क्या है इसमें, एक्स अ मैन्युफैक्चरर. ठीक है, यहाँ पे चार कॉलम बनाने पड़ेंगे फ्रेंड्स, वन मिनट. यस, इट इज विजिबल नाउ. एक्स इज अ मैन्युफैक्चरर, बी a distributor, X a wholesaler, R a retailer. You can read here. So what is told? Purchase plus addition, like we can, plus profit is equal to sales plus VAT is equal to invoice price. I'll read the question. Mr. X, a manufacturer, sells goods to Mr. B, a distributor, for 2000, excluding VAT. So here VAT is not included, so it is good. We can write here directly 2000 rupees. He is a manufacturer, he has sold goods 2000. He didn't include VAT, so we have to add VAT, because see, manufacturer cannot avail ITC because he is the first one. If it was a B, that is the wholesaler, then he could have availed, but he has directly manufactured and he is selling, so he has not paid anything. So 2000, add VAT, that is VAT rate 12.5%. So 2000 into 12.5%, I think it will come to 250. Then invoice price will come to 2250. Now here Mr. B has paid VAT, so credit will be available to Mr. B. So what we will write here, sale again 2400. It is given Mr. B sells goods to Mr. K, a wholesaler, means he has sold. So in the sale column we will write 2400, and here also VAT 300, 12.5%, it comes to 2700. Firstly, I am doing this, then I will tell you about VAT credit of all the persons. The wholesale dealers sells the goods to the retailer. This is a retailer. This is manufacturer, wholesaler, retailer, customer. So here it is given, sales goods to the retailer for 3000. So here, no, manufacturer, distributor. Oh, I'm sorry, it's distributor. He is wholesaler, he is retailer. The sum is right, friends. Manufacturer sales goods 2000, VAT is 250, 2250. Mr. B sales 2400, we have to add VAT 300, 2700. Now here it is given, Mr. K, a wholesale dealer for rupees 2400. The wholesaler dealer sales goods to the retailer for 3000. So here we'll write 3000. Here again 12.5%, 375, it comes to 3375, and who ultimately sells to the consumer 4000. Like retailer sells for 4000, he'll charge 12.5% VAT, which comes to 500. So it will be 4500. Now VAT liability is this. So VAT liability is 250, 300, 375, 500 minus VAT credit. Here zero, as I told you, he is manufacturer, so he has to, here he has paid 250, I told you, so this credit will be available to him. So here 250, that is 50. Here 300, this amount he has paid na, so he'll get credit, so it is 75. And here 375, as he has paid, he'll get 125. So if you add all this, net VAT liability will come. You can check in the module also. 250 plus 50, 75, 125. 250 plus 50 plus 75 plus 125. It is very easy. Some students don't able to understand this question because it is a little clumsy, that four persons are included, manufacturer, distributor, wholesaler, retailer. We don't have to do anything. Manufacturer is very easy. 2000, they have given that it is not including of VAT, so we charge VAT 250. This will be available as credit to this. Then the invoice price is 2250. Now 2250 invoice price. Then here he is given that sale he has done 2400, means he has, it is including I'll tell you 2250. It is including a VAT. So you remove VAT. So the bare purchase is 2000 rupees. Plus, I think he has added, he has paid 250 rupees. Means this is the bare purchase VAT credit available, which we have deducted from here 250. So 2000, and he sells to the wholesaler for 2400, means his profit is 400. So he ultimately sells 2400. Here we have to charge VAT on 12.5%. This is it. Then VAT liability is 300, and he has paid 250 here. So he'll get the credit. Likely all the four chains are to be calculated. If you want, I can tell you the third chain also, like 2700 minus 300. So 2000, it comes to 2400. We removed VAT. So 2400 is the bare purchase, and 300 is the VAT credit available, which we have deducted from here. VAT credit is available. So 2400 plus 600 is his profit. So 3000, he has made sale of 3000 rupees, or 3000 amount ka usne sale kiya hai. So it is 3000. Add VAT 12.5%, it comes to 375. So VAT liability is 375 minus his credit is 300. So it is 75. It is very easy. Like this, it's done of retailer also. Now we'll do question number 9. I think question number 9. Yeah, question is here, answer is here. So it's okay. Here it is told, Mr. Y, a dealer, purchase goods 2,50,000. So it is good purchase. It's not including VAT. So 2,50,000 is the purchase. Exclusive of VAT means VAT is not included. So VAT rate on purchase and sale is 4%, means we have paid 4% VAT on this. So 4% comes to 10,000 rupees. So this is the VAT credit available. This is the VAT credit available. So purchase is 2,50,000. It is exclusive, means VAT is not included. So VAT which we have paid is 10,000. So it is purchased 2,50,000 plus he incurs 35,000 on goods, means there is some addition, or we can say some cost is there. So add additions, he has done 35,000 rupees. It comes to 2,85,000 rupees. Then here it is given, and sells them at a profit of 15,000. That means his profit is 15,000. So it comes to 3 lakh. It is sale price. Plus if you add VAT, it is 4%, that is 12,000. It becomes invoice price. So VAT liability here 12,000 minus VAT credit available, this is 10,000. So net VAT payable is 2,000. We can check also here, tax payable under VAT 2,000 rupees. This was the question number 9. Now we'll do question number 10. So this is the last question. Rest all you practice. If there is anything which you are not able to understand, or any numerical, you can comment in the comment box and I will surely tell you the solution. So question number 10 of the module. Mr. X regularly pays excise duty and VAT on his manufacture and sales activities respectively. He seeks your advice while calculating the value added tax. Purchase from local market. So there is purchase. Firstly, it is inclusive. So alag kar do, VAT ko hata do. Kitna hai? 12.5. Bole to ye kitna hai? 112.5. To 100 ke barabar kitna? 125,000. So bare purchase, वो bare purchase word सही नहीं है, पर मैं आपको समझाने के लिए बोल रहा हूँ. Bare purchase 125,000 है, और ये minus कर देंगे तो VAT amount यानी VAT credit जो बचे हुआ है वो है 15625. नहीं तो आप ये भी कर सकते हैं 140 625 डिवाइडेड बाय 112.5 इंटू 100, ये आपका बेयर परचेस निकल गया। और फिर ये 100 अगर परचेस है तो 12.5 वैट है, तो 1140625 डिवाइडेड बाय 112.5 इंटू 12.5 करेंगे तो आप वैट भी निकल जाएगा, पर 100 का ये कर दिए तो जो बैलेंस है वो वैट आ गया। सो दिस इज वैट क्रेडिट अवेलेबल। नाउ परचेस इट इज गिवन, आपने अपन ने निकाला है 1,25,000 प्लस यहाँ दिया है मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एक्सपेंसेस अमाउंट टू 75,000। दैट इज कोई भी एक्सपेंस रहो वैट में इतना ईजी है, सबको धपा धपा ऐड करो आप 75,000, ये हो गया 2,00,000। उसने बोला है यहाँ प्रॉफिट भी, ये देखिए प्रॉफिट ऑन 80%, प्रॉफिट ऑन कॉस्ट एट 80%, इसका 80% करो, इसका कितना होता है 1,16,000 नहीं 1,60,000। तो ये आ गई एसेसेबल वैल्यू 3,60,000, क्योंकि इधर एक्साइज का लफड़ा है बोल के एसेसेबल वैल्यू पे एक्साइज ड्यूटी कैलकुलेट होती है। एक्साइज 10.30%, सो इट इज 37080। एक्साइज ड्यूटी एसेसेबल वैल्यू पे होती है, उसके बाद आता है सेल प्राइस, ये आ गया 397080। इस पर आप वैट चार्ज कर दीजिए, क्वेश्चन में दिया है आउटपुट वैट इज 12.5%, इस पर आप 12.5% चार्ज कर दीजिए, ये आएगा 49635। सो इनवॉइस प्राइस कितनी आ गई 517644, ये इनवॉइस प्राइस आ गई। वापस वैट लाइबिलिटी कितनी है 49635, ये वाली। वैट क्रेडिट कितना है 15625, यहाँ निकाला है 15625। सो वैट लाइबिलिटी फाइनल इट इज 34010। सो दिस इज इट, आई हैव डन 6-7 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ वैट of the module. If you have any problem relating to any of the question, please comment. अगर आपको ये वीडियो पसंद आया तो please like करो यार, thank you very much. और आपको ये वीडियो अगर पसंद आया तो मैं customs का भी पूरा वीडियो बना दूंगा, तो please मुझे comment box में comment करके बताइए कि आपको ये समझ में आ रहे हैं numericals या नहीं, और अगर समझ में आ रहे हैं तो कमेंट कर दीजिए तो मैं कस्टम्स के भी पूरा थ्योरी के साथ न्यूमेरिकल पूरा कस्टम का कर दूंगा, क्योंकि जीएसटी रहा तो भी कस्टम इज एज इट इज़, नो टच इज डन ऑन कस्टम, एक्साइज सर्विस टैक्स एंड वैट एंड सीएसटी यू मीन्स दे हैव बीन एकत्र केला आहे, सर्व वैट सीएसटी सर्विस टैक्स एक्साइज एक हो गया है, पर कस्टम्स अलग है। तो वैट तो ठीक है क्योंकि जीएसटी वैट जैसा ही है, यानी वैट के ही प्रोविजंस बहुत सारे उठाए हैं कंजम्पशन बेस्ड टैक्स वगैरह जीएसटी का भी। तो आपको अगर वैट समझ में आया है तो मैं कस्टम्स समझा दूंगा, एक्साइज और सर्विस टैक्स और सीएसटी क्योंकि अभी चले जाएगा जीएसटी की वजह से तो वो मैं नहीं समझाऊंगा। तो अगर आपको ये पसंद आया तो लाइक करिए और मैं कस्टम्स का वीडियो लेके आऊँगा। थैंक यू वेरी मच।